Gary Lane Enterprises present Paradise, Louisiana. With Gary Risponi and Don Dubuque. Paradise, Louisiana is also brought to you by Baton Rouge Coca-Cola Bottling Company, Benny's Car Wash and Oil Change, Cracker Barrel Convenience Stores. We have more than you expect. Always fresh, never frozen, Raising Cane's. Blue Cross Blue Shield of Louisiana. Louisiana Fish Fry Products. Demco. First South Farm Credit. Pro Drive Outboards. Area Wholesale Tire Company with tire programs for tire dealers. And by Farm Bureau Insurance.
Welcome to the Backyard Barbecue Edition of Paradise, Louisiana. I'm Gary Risponi.
I'm Don Dubuque. I'm for doing this every week.
You like this?
Well, TJ Ribs is nice, but hey, this is good too.
Well, TJ Ribs would have to be close. We had to give them a break, but Chris did a great job on that teal breast, and sausage. It was good. I wish I could have ate longer. You know, before we had to go to work, we might have beat the rain. Don, this rain has been crazy. It's supposed to be just a little rain, and it's a lot of rain. It ain't supposed to be much rain, and it's no rain. So I'm glad I'm not in the weather business, but we are in the fishing business, and boy, we got some great reports coming in. Fish are back biting again. Got to find clear water. So, but what you got this week?
Well, I made a nice trip down with Captain Ryan Lambert, Cajun Fishing Adventures. Went over there to Point Lahash. Found some redfish in the grass. It was kind of like doing an Easter egg hunt. We were hunting for Easter redfish in the marsh grass over there. Good clean water too. Using spinnerbaits.
Spinnerbait all the way.
A lot of fun. We'll show you that. Been a lot of turkeys killed. Unfortunately, I had a very close encounter, and to make the story short, I still have two tags left.
Well, ain't that something, huh?
Shouldn't have one.
We got a couple more turkey pictures.
Mm-hmm.
A man that went to school with you at Catholic school in the elementary, and then he went to
East Jefferson. Yeah.
And then while you was at Rommel, but he used to follow you in sports.
Yeah, he was a lot younger. He was a little younger than me.
You don't have to be humble, but he told me. Now, you know, all the state championships, everything, all the great athletes coming out of Rommel, that you was the best running back he ever saw come out of Rommel.
See?
Now, and look, and he still follows. I say, well, you must have forgot, because that was back in the 30s. But he paid you a great compliment. And he's a great turkey hunter, and he had a great turkey hunt in St. Tammany.
His name is Jerry Cross, and not only is he a good turkey hunter, he knows athletes too, right? He's pretty good at that. What else we got?
We got Eric Tomplay. He's from Wild Turkey Federation. Him and his buddy, Eric shot it, his buddy videoed it. We got a little video of him killing another turkey, a little short video. Really appreciate that. Y'all can send us. If they're clear and good, send it to me. We'll use it. Saves me money, too. You know that?
That's true.
I don't have to pay Gary Krause or Chris. So, yeah, you send it to me. And we got a little video on that. We got some more pictures of turkey. We got fish. We got first-time fish. We got a great fish report from Toledo Bend. Vent calendar is full and important things that normally we just run the vent calendar, but I tell you what, these have to be announced. So, just stay tuned, Don. And we got the fish report, and what else?
Well, we'll find out. You never know. We'll be right back with the barbecue from the backyard edition of Paradise, Louisiana. I think he's got one more thing.
I forgot. Yeah, I wrote it down, too. We're going to go to front and back.
Good idea.
With Ken Sherman, and going to tell you what to do if you did like we did and set a boat up too long.
All right. All coming up right here on Paradise, Louisiana.
GM Cable, locally owned and operated since 1984, has grown from a one-man shop to a family company with more than 90 employees. For more than two decades, GM Cable has established itself as one of the most trusted contractors in Louisiana. GM Cable specializes in fiber optic installation, video surveillance, directional boring, aerial and outdoor construction, and much more. Log on to gmcable.com to learn more about this rock-solid local company. GM Cable, improving the standards of communication.
Benny's Car Wash and Oil Change has been keeping cars and trucks in Baton Rouge clean and running smooth for over 50 years. At Benny's, we feature professional car washing, complete detailing, high-tech waxing and buffing, interior cleaning, and tire shine. Benny's, one stop for car maintenance with complete oil and lube services and even state inspections at our express locations. Visit one of our five convenient locations, including our newest store on Greenwell Springs Road. And don't forget to stop by Be Quick Convenience Store and Fuel Stop. Benny's Car Wash and Oil Change. Drive in dirty, drive out clean.
When you're ready to really enjoy life at a slower pace, become a landowner. First South Farm Credit specializes in financing and refinancing land, but not just for farmers. They offer loans to purchase timberland, hunting and fishing, or recreational property. Their experience in land, timber, and loans set them apart from standard lending institutions. Contact a First South Farm Credit loan officer for more information. First South Farm Credit, a specialized rural land investment lender helping you realize your dream.
Welcome back to Paradise, Louisiana. And Gary, I got a chance to go down to one of my favorite fishermen's lodges, Cajun Fishing Adventures. Captain Ryan Lambert got into some red fishing down there, found a spot that he was even surprised to see as much grass this early. I'm talking about grass that waterfowl like, stacked up with gray ducks, a lot of teal that were returning were down there. It was good to see that some of those were still around. We even saw some of his duck blinds, the reeds from where he had hunted. You couldn't get to them right now. There's so much silt, despite that river being as high as, almost as high as I've ever seen it down there right now.
Been a long time, that's right. It's on flood stages right now. They're gonna be checking the Bonnie Carey spillway. They're gonna be checking the locks just to be cautious. Now, it's not predicted to have to open them, but they're doing it. And you know, if y'all saw the Sunday Advocate, you know, Joe had a great article on him, and you know, you've been with him. We've been doing stories on him. So much about this nature refinishing the marsh. You know, they're talking about all these diversions, and he's talking about diversions that are already there without even spending money. Mm-hmm. And it's a big controversy, but he's offered to take anybody or group. If you call him, he'll take you down there and show you what is happening right there, right now. No ifs, ands, or buts. If you can't figure it out, shame on you.
Well, the day we picked to go with him was not what you call ideal conditions. Wasn't much tide. As we mentioned, there was a high river, full moon, but Ryan came through and knew a spot where we could locate some redfish. He, I, and my nephew, Iron Mike, made this trip, and it was right before Easter, so he talked about when you get conditions like that, if you got other days you can go, you might want to do that and offered some alternatives. Here's Captain Ryan Lambert, Cajun Fishing Adventures.
All right.
It's a good start.
You know, you take a day like today, we got a strong east wind, we got a front coming in, we got 1 inch of tide. Today's the first day of the flip-flop, so it's coming up 1 inch. So, you know, you got the figure. Go to where you can get some reaction hits. So go ahead and fish redfish. Take a bait like a spinnerbait, like we did, that they'll hit just out of reaction where they don't have to come up and look at it much. And we went in some grass beds that's coming up. You know, it's early March, it's April, and grass is just starting to come up. So we just got in the grass and went and seek and destroy. I mean, that's what you got to do on a day with no tide.
Somebody. You got the net? Yeah, he's in the net now.
You know, that's where the fresh water is coming out the river, out of that canal. And as you can see, it makes that aquatic vegetation. And that's really key to putting those fish and bait in there, crabs in there, because all the juveniles of every species go and get in that, and that's where they raise up. So you just have a bunch of good things coming together right there. But I've never seen it this early that good. I mean, it's thick. It's going to be one heck of a summer.
Oh, yeah. All right. So if you're coming fishing after this late spring frontal system, pay attention to Captain Ryan's advice, and this is what you're going to find.
Third Tahoe.
And I'm on my fourth Chevy Silverado pickup. It's always been
Chevy. Hey, you know I've had 4 Camaros and 5 Corvettes. Got them all from Jerry Lane.
We're proud to be a Jerry Lane family. Always lead to
you can count on Jerry. Introducing Powerade Ion 4, complete with 4 electrolytes lost in sweat. Powerade Ion 4, the complete sports drink.
How y'all doing today? I'm Ken Sherman, front-to-back boat service here in Baton Rouge, Louisiana. I'm here today to discuss some boat maintenance tips to make your boating adventures be a whole lot better. Things that you didn't do that may have issues this year, I'm gonna show you some things to do to try to help prevent them, one, and two, to try to work through them and get this thing going so you can make a trip this year. Well, one thing that we really want to look at that's real important, my books, and I see it as a safety deal. When your boat's been sitting up, we know we don't always check nuts and bolts. One thing I like to do is come in here and check all my steering nuts and bolts here, check all my jack plate nuts and bolts to make sure everything's good, secure, and tight. Check the motor bolts that's bolting the boat motor to the jack plate and the jack plate to the boat if you have that. Go around your engine as well while you got the wrench in your hand, and you can check your lower unit bolts, which is very critical. Through the vibration, the pounding, the beating, and the running of this boat, these are some things that happen over the course of time. These bolts do vibrate loose. So when you're going through your schedule, some things that you want to do is check these nuts and bolts. Once all that's tight, some other things that we like to do is we like to back up here, checking steering. Steering is another very important part of the fishing day, because without steering, you're not going anywhere. Loose steering, you could be in the woods, or you could be on a rock bed, or just depending on where you're fishing at. One thing we look at is we see oil leaks that come from right around the steering cylinders. You'll be able to drag your finger under the bottom of it, and if you drag your finger under the bottom, you'll see a little oil leak like this right here. This one actually has it, and this is a fairly new boat. It's not that he did anything wrong on this one, it's just it's a leaking seal. This happens over the course of time because of the amount of torque off of this motor. So one thing you want to look at is you check that right under, and you'll check for slack in your steering wheel. So when you turn your motor, you want to get a positive response. And so when you get it, you don't want your steering wheel to turn a quarter, a half, or even a complete turn before the engine starts to move. That means you have air in your line. We need to get it bled out. And if you find that oil underneath the steering seal, we need to get them steering seals changed. Something you want to do for your sake to make sure that that's taken care of. You'll have to do that at the shop. We do sell kits that will repair that, and you can do it yourself with a tool. Once you kind of got all of that down, that's the nuts and bolts of the motor that you're more concerned about. Here's something that's very critical on these motors, is batteries. The hookups, the connections, corrosion builds up, cause these batteries to not deliver the proper voltage to the engine. It can cause starter problems, can cause battery problems as well. One thing you want to do is make sure your connectors are good and tight, positive and negative. If you see any green corrosion or fungus growing on this stuff, you want to take a wire brush, scrub that off real good. One thing we find is we use CRC, Corrosion X, heavy duty spray. We spray it on the top of them to eliminate the moisture or the air from getting onto the top of them and causing a corrosion body with the heat that's coming off of this thing right here. You can use Vaseline, works real well too for those that have plenty of that around the house. Some type of petroleum-based jelly works real well to keep the corrosion down. Very important part of keeping the battery up is keeping the corrosion off of the terminals. Other thing that we do is fuel stabilizers. We run here, I recommend Ultimax, which is a local company here in town. We run and promote that product because I've had real good success with it. I've had engines that spit and sputter and run bad, and we put an extra dose of this in it. So instead of mixing it for a 5-gallon dose, we'll mix it for a 10-gallon dose. Whatever the blend is in what we're doing, we actually double that. And when we double that, that runs a very rich fuel mixture of this chemical through the engine, and it actually helps unclog fuel filters, it unclogs fuel injectors, and actually unclogs fuel pumps. Still going to want to change that fuel filter. That's something you want to do that yearly anyway, but it will take any of the little particles that break down that get stuck in the fuel filter, and it will break them down and run them through the engine. Something that we're seeing a lot of still today is this E10 fuel, the 10% ethanol fuel. We still have a ton of boats out there, and you may have a boat that has that line on it, and you can look at it and see if you've got a fuel line that is hard as a brick, there's a real good possibility you have a fuel line problem. Highly recommend changing fuel line and primer bulb. And then what you can do is take a razor knife, cut that open, and you're most probably going to see a lot of your problems of why your motor's not running up to speed on RPM wise. You may find out and see why your motor's spitting and sputtering and missing real bad, because when you cut it open, there'll be a brown, tannish looking gunk, and it'll come out like, I mean gunk. When I'm telling you gunk, if it dries out, it's going to be like a powder. If it's wet, it's going to be like gunk. So you want to look at that right under. That's very important to do. Make sure all your connections are in good shape. Make sure your fuel filters are changed. Make sure you run this additive. You don't need to run it every time, but I'm going to tell you what, I would run it at a minimum of every other trip to every third trip. You run these, you can run stay build. You can run Yamaha builds some fuel stabilizers. Mercury builds fuel stabilizers. The Ultimax, which again is what I recommend, is one that I've had great success with, and I've tried all of them. I'm not saying that that's the only one. I'm just saying that there's several out there, and I would at least give one of them a try. The secret to that stuff is use it all year, and if you're using it all year, when you go to put the boat up at the end of the year, you make sure that your last dosage of gas has a blend of Stay-Build, Ultimax, or whatever you want to run in it. You make sure that's in there. I can just about guarantee you most probably won't have a missing or spitting or sputtering running engine the next year. Here's something that's real important that a lot of people really overlook, is the prop. How often do we take one off? I can tell you, most probably not near enough. One thing I recommend is try to take this prop off about every month or two at least. One thing you want to do is look behind the prop. Everybody has a habit of throwing monofilament over or rope, or you pick up some rope that's floating down the river. You'll pick it up and it'll get sucked inside this prop. There's shaft seals inside of here. See them things ate up a whole lot. If that happens, you're going to get water in your lower unit. Could cause an issue. So you want to slide this off, check behind for monofilament or rope, grease up your shaft, put your prop back on. Something that's real critical too, running. Your boat's fuel mileage. You hear people talk about fuel mileage. With the price of gas, you want to make sure your prop's in the best condition you can get. If you look at this edge right here, you can see this edge is pretty boogered up right in here. It actually has a couple of waves in it. So you look, he's done run this thing up on some rocks. That right under could easily cost you 4 or 5 miles an hour. Gas mileage would be real bad too. So you want to try to make sure you get this taken care of as well.
All righty, guys, girls, hopefully with these tips that I offered today will help you get out on the water, make sure everything's going good. Remember, you want to check your steering seals, your steering. You want to check your nuts and bolts on your boat, your jack plate, your motor, your lower unit. You want to check your battery connections. You want to make sure you put that fuel treatment in the gas. If you do all of that, next year when you get out on the water, and that's done before next year, when you get there, next year will be a whole lot easier to do. Come by and see us at Front to Back Boat Service. If you can't get your boat running, we'll be glad to help you out. Give us a buzz or come by. Hope to see you on the water and safe trips.
We build tires, but not tires like anybody else. We build Cooper tires for people, not just cars. People who are chauffeurs and shuttle pilots, heavy haulers and heavy hitters. More than what your Cooper tires can do, it's about what you can do with your Cooper tires. Life's a road trip. Come on, let's go.
Fishing, it's where good stories come from. It's about good times and family and friends. It's about taking a couple home for dinner tonight and saving a few for tomorrow. It's all about that and so much more. To CCA, fishing is about enjoying today and making sure tomorrow is even better. To us, fishing comes with a responsibility for the resources we enjoy so much. If fishing means all that to you, then you belong with CCA.
Hi, my name is Clayton Schilling. I'm one of the tournament directors for Bayou Coast Kayak Fishing Club. This is our second tournament of our Angler of the Year series. This is Yakka Bass. We're out here at Chico State Park, and the anglers are going to be trying to catch three largemouth bass today. This is a catch, photo, and release tournament. So the angler catches the fish, put it on a board. We got these fancy orange wristbands. Make sure that's in the picture so that we know you fished today. And so that's what we're looking for. Total overall length of the three fish. So we got an 8-inch minimum on the bass, and we're gonna see them come out and get the longest aggregate total length.
Well, I mean, a lot of the tactics are the same. You're looking for ambush points. You're looking for places where the fish will be. With bass right now, I don't know if they're spawning yet. You're kind of looking for places they might bed down where the warmer water is. So similarities, but one of the things here is the cypress trees are all up around you, and I have been losing baits in the trees, tangling up, almost lost a rod yesterday. So really just fishing in brush. It's a different experience in the wide open spaces of the marsh.
So this is our first freshwater event. We have yet to do an actual bass tournament. And we know that there are obviously a lot of bass fishermen in Louisiana, and a lot of kayak fishermen, and a lot of guys who really enjoy coming out and doing the bass fishing. We've had a great turnout for this tournament. And it's something we can do to kind of stretch and grow the anglers of the club. A lot of these guys in the kayak club are saltwater fishermen. I've heard a lot of them talking this morning that this is their first time, coming out to Chico, and really first time bass fishing. They mostly concentrate on saltwater, so this is new for them, which is a great thing, a new experience, learn some new technique, and hopefully learn how to catch some bass.
Well, I'm a red fisherman, so it's kind of a different thing. I've got started out yesterday with 7 bass lures in my tackle box. I've lost 2 of them. So I got 5 lures to fish with today. Gonna get out there, we're gonna look for some clean water. We're gonna head north, probably northwest a little bit, and just hope we can get on them and find a hungry fish. A lot of guys coming in with skunks the last 3 days, and we're gonna work hard and see what we can do.
Yeah, I was kind of hoping somebody would launch.
Yeah, right.
Just like intimidate them. Like, come on.
The photo be taken at the time that the fish is caught. You can't put it in the ice chest and bring it back up.
Oh,
out here on beautiful, scenic Chico Lake, Chico State Park, and we're trying to do a little bass tournament. And typically we go coastal fishing, but we're trying to get a little bit into bass fishing also, have a little diversity. And what we're looking for is we're in the pre-spawn right now. So if you see some motion up on the banks, some cloudy beds or something, that's something to look for. Also, if you have some that have already spawned, you have some little males cruising the banks and running bait off, that's something to focus on also. I'm gonna go back in this swamp. Making the transition from inshore to a beautiful lake like this with all the trees are one of the challenges are the trees. We're used to just winging it, having wide open casts. Whereas these guys are having to learn how to cast under the limbs, skipping baits, things like that. And where I'm putting my rods down, I don't have them all standing up, so I'm laying them down on the side. So I can crawl underneath these trees and make some low trajectory cast and skip it underneath them. And so that's our biggest challenge is limbs and whatnot. The fishing's really tough right now. This year is a little bit tougher, dirty water and whatnot. So the benefit about coming here is the scenery. You get to look at all kind of cool things, seeing all kind of animals that we typically don't see along the coast, and gators, all kind of nice scenery. So that's the plus side.
Louisiana Farm Bureau Insurance doesn't hire celebrities to push auto coverage. We think people might like to make decisions based on service and savings, not just because that guy from that show says it's a good idea. Instead of faces you know from your TV, we offer faces you know from your neighborhood. Because we're based in Louisiana, with local agents right in your town. That's really the only thing we want to be famous for. Louisiana Farm Bureau Insurance. Real service, real people.
I can't believe y'all brought me out in this blind and we ain't got no food.
Don't worry, Gary. This will be over quick.
Man, I'm hungry.
Get out, Gary. Here they come. That dog loves to hunt.
I really like hunting, but you know what I really love?
I know, Gary. Food.
Now I can eat. Cane's, the official chicken of Louisiana Outdoors.
Roger Kador, Southern University.
Ron Maestri, University of New Orleans.
And I'm Paul Maneri, LSU.
We have over 100 years of coaching experience, but today we're going to go out and have fun. I'm going to push Roger in the water, I'm going to lip Maneri with a hook, and I'm going to catch all the fish.
Oh, man.
What you looking for?
Is that a spick?
Only 49 left.
Oh, okay, we're right. 49 left.
Catch all the fish already.
Begin this luck, Paul. Put the boat.
Right there.
I got one, too.
Mine's just fighting.
A midget.
It's a midget. It might be one of those flying carp. All right, here's one of the big three, right, Coach Farminary, Coach. I can't tell you how much I appreciate you coming here and being part of Paradise, Louisiana. You took a lot of ragging. Last night, you learned how to play Blu-ray. There's a lot of things you did. But tell us about that one big redfish. I saw you catch, we were filming you from the other boat. What's the excitement of catching a redfish?
I'll tell you what, Gary. I've been fortunate enough in my lifetime to have a lot of great experiences. You know, in the profession that I'm in, there's a lot of exciting moments, a lot of big wins, championships, and so forth. I'm not sure I've ever been more excited or had more of an adrenaline rush than I did catching that old redfish today.
Think of the spectators you had, your former coach, and then Coach Cater. You know, he gets excited himself.
I know Ron Maestri and Roger Cater were a little bit jealous, you know, watching me reel that big baby in. Because what they did is they just caught them little speckled trout out there all day long, you know. But I went for the big mama. I got that 14-pound redfish, and it put up quite a fight. I almost gave up, but, you know, I dug deep, and, you know, with all the fortitude and determination I could make, I finally got that thing into the boat. And I looked at poor Roger Cater over there, and he was just green with envy. It was unbelievable. But it was a lot of fun, I'll tell you, Gary. We had a ball out there today, and Andre Boudreau hosting us, and he was my coach. There's no way we could have pulled that redfish in without the way he was coaching me on doing it. I can promise you that. But we had a ball, and I'll tell you that this is a whole different world, you know, and people haven't experienced coming down here and doing the things that we've done here for the last 2 days. They need to do it, because I'll tell you, you forget about all the problems you have, and you just enjoy yourself. It was really a great time.
You know, Roger Trade and Coach Maestri did also live in this, and especially come to signing day, because you do get the first choice of some of the best recruits around. Coach, I want to ask you a question. We're talking about recruits right now, so if we got a kid in any state in the country, and he's a hunter and fisherman, he wants to come to Louisiana, thinking about coming to LSU, and he might ask a question, say, Coach, I'm a big outdoorsman. What they got to do in Louisiana?
Well, let's hope they're smart enough to figure this out. I mean, this is the paradise. This is it. If you're a hunter and fisherman, there's no place better than South Louisiana. That's, of course, obvious. But I grew up in Miami, Florida, and I wasn't a hunter or a fisherman, believe it or not. And, you know, to come up here to Louisiana and get exposed to this culture and this way of life is really amazing. So whether you come here as a fisherman or a hunter, or whether or not you come here and then want to learn it, it's equally beneficial to both groups. And but anybody that any youngster that loves to hunt and fish when they have time outside of classwork and baseball, you know, they obviously are in heaven down here. I think of all the boys that I've coached here at LSU, the two boys that have loved fishing more than anybody are the two Nola boys, Austin Nola and Aaron Nola. And of course, when I caught my redfish today out in the middle of the water out there, I had to take a picture of it and send them a text message. So I already heard back from both of them. They were very proud of their old coach.
I'm very proud of you too. You know, a lot of people don't know, and I know from being in the TV business, your wife is the best fisherman in the family. She comes from Louisiana, and she was brought up fishing. I heard the first time she went with you, and some other fisherman, I won't mention his name, Jeff Kennedy, she strapped it on me.
Well, you obviously were talking to Karen, but you know, Karen is without a doubt the best fisherman in our family. She much better than I am, and my children haven't had enough exposure to it, but Karen's love of fishing in Louisiana comes from her father. Her dad, Bill Feegis, who my father-in-law unfortunately has passed, but when I was in college at the University of New Orleans, he used to take me out here. And he taught me how to fish these waters and catch the specks and the redfish. And we had more fun doing that. And I know before I met him, before I started dating his daughter, that he used to take his daughters out all the time. And that's where Karen's love of fishing began. And, you know, I readily admit she's a much better fisherman than I am. She can do it all. She loves the water, and I don't get her out here or get her out enough out on the water.
Well, go Tigers and bring them down here. And we'll go get that master change.
We're going to do our best, Gary.
Coach Ron Maestri, everybody's asked you questions about baseball, why you come back, after all these years, but to me, you're a fisherman. You're a true fisherman, because I watched you today catch fish after fish. I watched it where you fled. I saw Coach Manette, one of your students. You're going to have to work with him a little bit longer, but he got a lot of promise. Just like you coached him in New Orleans today, what do you think, the promise of him being a good fisherman?
I think he's got promise. You know, he caught that one. He caught that one big one, but, you know, that was in the first inning. And so, you know, you just don't catch the one, you don't hit a home run in the first inning and then shut it down. And he did that today, and we caught the rest of the fish. But he's got some promise. He really does.
Coach, you know, I was going to ask the same question to the other two coaches the other day. If there's a young man you're recruiting and he asks you, he comes from a part of the state that, you know, a state that hunts and fish, or he's brought up hunting and fishing, what would you tell him about coming to Louisiana and his chances to hunt fish?
Well, there's no question. We got the greatest hunting and fishing in the country, and maybe in the world for that matter. You know, I've had a number of kids while I was out at the Zephyrs, professional players that love to fish, and they call me still. I've taken them up bass fishing. They're in the big leagues. Of course, when I catch a big one, I always send it to them. But when they come back through here, they want to go fish. And it's just a tribute to the kind of fishing that we have here. I mean, here in Cocodrie, you go to Fushan, you go down to Venice, you go into Lake Pontchartrain. We fish there. You don't get better fishing, you don't get better people, and you don't get better eating. And so when kids come down here and they indicate that they want to go fishing, they're just awed at what we have here. And it's a natural resource.
Well, Coach, you know, I wanted to ask you one other question. And I heard you telling stories last night, and you had everybody cracked up, best of Coach Manette. But tell us your funniest baseball story that you told last night. You told about three or four. Tell us your funniest.
The funniest was Paul Manette playing baseball at UNO. That was the funniest. No, I'm just kidding. I had, you know, there were so many experiences. I told you the story. Every year I go to Italy with the Italian Baseball Federation, and a hitter topped the ball down the first baseline. The first baseman picked it up, and you can either tag the runner or tag the base. Well, they had him in a rundown between home and first, and he slid into home plate. The umpire called him safe, and so they're still fighting over there.
That's the number one. It had to be from Italy. You're Italian, I'm Italian. You know,
well,
Manera's Italian.
Sammy, huh? Our boy here.
My brother Sammy here. Yeah. Yeah, and I saw he gave you a fava bean last night. You still got it?
Oh, I got fava beans. I got them up there at the banquet that year. I've got a fava bean that I had when I was coaching back in the 1980s, and I found it in an old jacket, and I'm going to keep that, and I appreciate it.
Thank you.
It means
Coach,
a lot to me.
Coach, thank you. It means a lot to me and Andre and everybody else that you came in and fished with us today.
Well, you and Sam, you know, and your whole crew are just great people, and what you do up there, I had the privilege, Sam and you invited me up to that banquet, and I never laughed so hard in all my life. And you had politicians, you had coaches, you got everybody there. And it's just a great time, it's great fellowship, and it's a credit to the response to what you guys do. And you know, it's something that I know a lot of people respect what you do in the community, and I'm just glad to be a part of it. Thank you.
Me too, thank God. Thank you.
You work hard to protect what is precious. We stand beside you, behind you, with caring doctors and nurses who work at Blue Cross to keep you healthy. You can count on us to help you. Protect every day.
Come to the family-owned and operated Cassius Casino in Port Allen today, where the Vegas-style video poker machines are ready for your entertainment. Cassius Casino is the finest, cleanest, classiest casino around. And Cassius 50-style diner is now serving seafood daily, along with your favorite home-cooked specials 24/7. Hey, Cassius is fun. Cassius is exciting. So come to the unsinkable Cassius Casino in Port Allen. over the river 2 miles west of exit 151.
Boom!
Did you get that?
Hell yeah.
Now what you just saw, which has been renewed many times this past month, we're talking about turkey hunting, and there's been a lot of success and there's been some not so much success, but weather-wise, we've had a pretty decent season. What you'd like for turkey season?
Yeah,
a couple weeks to go.
I want to thank Eric and his buddy for sending me that video, and the rest of y'all can do the same thing, especially when they come out that good. Yeah, you email them and we can use them, and I know people enjoy watching them as much as you enjoyed killing them, because there's been, well, you know, East Feliciana, St. Tammany, where these birds are coming from. Historically, that was one of the first places before they exploded and everybody's starting to manage the turkeys a little bit better. And they're getting around a little bit. But even at Louisiana, we're still not where other states are.
Oh, not even close. And really, send us your picture. I know it's certainly an honor. Anybody that goes out in Louisiana and comes back with a male gobbler turkey, you're a hunter in my book.
I've got some calls. Got some calls too from the people, and it's asked me that I get it and they like it, and they ain't had no luck since then. But like you, now I still want to hear your story.
I'll tell you. I told it on the radio Saturday morning, but I'll tell it to you a little bit later on. It's a little bit lengthy. By the way, while we're talking about hunting, squirrel season, we have a special May season. I'm hoping maybe this year people will get into it. We really haven't had a lot of participation in it.
Well, squirrel season this year on private land is May 2nd to May 24th. Now, from May 2nd to 10th, the wildlife management areas, but that's only Louisiana wildlife management areas. And you need to contact to make sure which ones that are holding the special spring squirrel season. You need to get in touch or go on the internet and with the Louisiana Department of Wildlife and Fisheries. Now, to close is Costache. Mm-hmm. They're not having a squirrel season, and any national wildlife refuge are doing it. And even the Army Corps Engineer land are not holding any squirrel season, spring squirrel season. I want to make that clear. Yeah, and look, we got so many events coming up, and but in the news, we want to give a shout out to David Cavell and Albert Collins. Thanks to Gary Krause, he follows all this and everything. The Basscat Boat Owners Invitational been going on Sam Raven for years. This is the second time in 3 years that David Cavell and Albert Collins. Now Albert Collins is one of the old used to fish the bass tournaments. He's from out of Mississippi, you know, he's coming there, but they had 33.3 pounds in 2 days, won a 2015 Basscat Puma with a 250 horsepower Mercury Pro X5. So congratulations. David Cavell has been hot. He's doing his own boat. He's been in the shop and running around. David brings us a lot of his news that you see around, and been promised to take me fishing again. But
yeah, well, you know, Baton Rouge boy David and Albert from Mississippi, so much for home cooking. We love to take that Texas money and bring it back across the border.
That's what I'm talking about. By the way, we're talking about good friends, Keith Delaney. We need to give us all the reports from the Alexandria area. Toledo Bend, we're talking about being hot. Well, he caught one. I'm going to send you a picture. He didn't have time to weigh it and see what it is, put it in his live well. If I know Keith, he probably went back and threw it back where he caught it from. There's so many. I think that fish came from the Indian Mound area. I'm not positive because he didn't say it, but his buddy Mike Clark was telling me that's where he thought it was coming from. He also, Toledo Bend, Gary Krause just wrote me something down right here. I got to see it. Where did he write it?
You're talking about the number of fish. I thought we would do that in the fishing report, but while we're talking about it, yeah,
well, I was
69 bass over 10 pounds that have qualified for the free replica mount
that's
program up there. That is really big time, and as they say in radio, the hits keep on coming. They're not done yet. There'll be more of those coming.
Yeah, David Vidrine, this is Lucky Rascal.
Mm-hmm.
He's on the 3rd or 4th of April, we just passed, from Ville Platte, had 11.5 and 11.21.
Back to back.
Completed bend. I don't know what Gary finds all. He don't tell us where they caught them and when they caught them. Make these quick down on these events. There was so many of them, but I still, they're so important. Trinity Outdoors, you know, the big tournament's coming up. It's going to be at 11th at Cabela's. I think that the team meeting's going to be at St. James Boat Club on that Thursday night before that. Also on April 10th, 11th, CCA Sporting Clays at Covey Rise. You can get in touch with the CCA website, and you find out if you want to go shoot. It's a two-day event, 10th and 11th, so don't forget that. Also on April 17th, we got the seminar April 17th, and then they also they got the Bayou Court, Paddlepalooza, April 17th and 18th. Now, also on April 17th, the seniors tournament out of Belle River at Pazan. So you get over there, early. You don't have to register early, but you can get in touch. You look at them in the paper. Joe got it in his event calendar also, and it'll be on our event calendar. April 18th, the Falls River Bass Club Trail. They're going to be at Spokane Landing in Lake St. John. And I've already told you right now about squirrel season, so that's it.
So the month of April, got a lot, no shortage of things to do. Just check on the websites of all these different organizations and get more details. And we'll be back with your Berkeley Abu Garcia Fishing Report right after this on our Barbecue in the Backyard edition of Paradise, Louisiana.
We build tires, but not tires like anybody else. We build Cooper tires for people, not just cars. People who are chauffeurs and shuttle pilots, heavy haulers and heavy hitters. More than what your Cooper tires can do, it's about what you can do with your Cooper tires. Life's a road trip. Come on, let's go.
As members of a Touchstone Energy cooperative, we've all got a job to do. And the more we work together, the more we save. That's the power of your co-op membership.
Demco, your Touchstone Energy Cooperative.
Who doesn't want to save money on fuel? Now, Shell and the Fuel Rewards Network are putting you in control of how much you pay for fuel. Simply buy whatever's on your shopping list. Clothes, groceries, even dinner out. And earn cents per gallon savings at participating retailers nationwide. Now, fuel prices are in your hands. So why wait? Sign up at FuelRewards.com today and turn shopping power into saving power.
Visit Cracker Barrel convenience stores before heading fishing or hunting. We have more than you expect.
You can count on Jerry Lane.
At Jerry Lane, they rolled the red carpet out for me.
It's always been Jerry. Jerry Lane.
You know what? It's tradition, it's family, and that's what keeps us coming back to Jerry Lane.
Get the lane, get the lane.
We're a Jerry Lane family.
All lanes lead to you can count on Jerry Lane.
Welcome to the Berkeley Abu Garcia Fishing Report. And Gary, we got to start off with freshwater. We talked a lot about Toledo Bend, but it's worth talking about a little bit more because it is a hot spot in the state right now.
Yeah, Sacolet, and what's amazing, how high it is, they're catching fish in shallow water. Now, I got a report from Dwayne Chapman. Under a cork now, I was telling you, they were fishing in 3 foot of water, and they were fishing a roadrunner now, under 3 foot of cork, and whether they were moving it, they're taking a Bobby Garland bluegrass plastic and putting it on it, and then catching some Bufu Sacolet, sent me a picture. That's from Toledo Bend. As far as Sacolet elsewhere, you know, when I fished that tournament over there, that passed the Pro Bass Challenge, a lot of people was on this side. Even with that whole front, they were catching 15, 20. Every time I'd ask a boat, you know, what you catching? They said, we're catching a few. Earlier, they weren't catching much, but I saw them again back midday, and some of them had 15, some of them had 18. They're catching Sacolet. That's Bulltail. That's all up in Pass Bay, Bay Natchez, all in that area. And I can tell you again, I had some other pictures people sent me from Bayou Corn. There's some pictures coming from there. They're catching Sacolet, big Sacolet, too. I mean, they're monsters, big slabs. I can tell you again, Rusty Capo caught some up in that area around Bay Alcid in those areas. So that's them areas. By the way, we're talking about Lake Goss, where everybody was catching those fish. They shut down. There's so much grass that's growed up. They're doing it. But they moved to Salvador, the Lake Salvador Wildlife Management Area. I got some reports coming from there for Sacolet, so you can check them out. And then bass is still, and Sacolet and everything in the Bayou Black area. The Bayou Black area, they're talking about the Bluebird Canal. What's the other canals? Gary and them will talk about the Schoolboard Canal, all of them canals are running off the main canal coming out of Bayou Black.
You know, another place worth talking about is that Bayou Bienvenue complex where we've been getting so many pictures of big bass coming in. Well, Jeff Brule couldn't stand it. He went out there looking for those bass armed with rivets and Texas rigging worms. He caught a combination of redfish, speckled trout. He did catch some bass. He said there's lots of them out there in the 1 to 2 pound range, but he didn't find any of those big ones. But they are there, so that's a good spot if you'd like to go try to make a mix.
You know,
catch.
I told him I was going to talk to the guy that sent me the report where he was catching those big ones, but I just ain't had time to get to him. So I apologize, Jeff, but you're still going to go out. He don't let the grass.
No, he ain't gonna wait. He'll go get them. All right, saltwater wise, I got some better reports from Lake Pontchartrain. Mike Gallo picked up some 1 to 2 pound fish, fishing with live shrimp. He said they're not scattered and stretched out all across the bridges. They're in pockets. But when you find them, if you stop on them and you catch a few right there, you can move on and pick up probably 15 to 20 good keeper speckled trout. Tofield Bourgeois, if you can make it out to the Chandelier Islands, he goes by plane. If you got a boat that's seaworthy enough to get you there and back, either out of Venice or out of Hopedale, the bull redfish are absolutely crazy. He sent me a video. He was using a GoPro with John Jackson, and he's actually got a picture of the redfish inhaling, swallowing the GoPro. You can see the crushes. First it goes dark, and then you see the crushes in the redfish gullet. He said it is a no-brainer to catch all the bull reds you want out there right now. Moving out further offshore, Iron Mike and some of his buddies, we're having a Rummel Beast Feast. In addition to wild game, we do seafood. They went out to catch some fish. They came back with five-man limits of blackfin tuna, amberjack, and red snapper all in one trip going out of Venice. Good fishing out there if you can get the weather right.
Got to get the weather right. That's what them reports I've been getting. But you see the snapper, you know, Tommy Vidrine and Bucky Cresson, all them and their wives, they still hurting them right now. They're catching snapper, also catching mangrove snapper. And they're not running far. They're running maybe 25 miles within 20, 30 miles for sure, coming out and all in the legal area.
While we were fishing with Captain Ryan, and you saw that footage earlier, we were catching those nice slot-sized redfish with spinnerbaits. One of his guides took some clients out, and they were catching bull reds. And Gary, I've been saying this for years, Louisiana charter captains have been missing the boat on bull redfish, how popular and how people like that. Most guides, they're all about trout, and they get a redfish on it, and they curse it because it takes too long to get it in and get it off. Finally, people are starting to recognize the value and the fun of going out and catching those bull reds. Even though you can't keep a bunch of them, the catch is
you
what
don't
makes
want to keep
worthwhile.
A bunch of them because a lot of them they're not as good eating and they want it the perfect size to keep. But you can catch your limit right around there by accident. You can catch your limit of five, but you fight those bull reds, especially if you want to help tourism. You want to tell
Absolutely.
People about it. Once you fight a bull red, you know it's almost like, you know, we heard the story about Jack Gravel,
right?
You know, the guy's bass, we asked him what his favorite fish to come to Louisiana. He said, put me on a Jack Gravel, because that is the sportiest fish in the world.
True.
I don't know anybody that eats a Jack Gravel but Don.
I got a recipe called Gravel Accent. If you want it, it's on my website. Speaking of my website, the next outdoor opinion poll I'm planning on putting up, did you know that Mississippi is considering allowing the keeping of bull redfish in offshore waters? They're going to be considering that at the Mississippi Department of Wildlife and Fisheries. They're going to let charter captains keep one over 27 outside if it passes. And that's going to come up for discussion, not just in Mississippi. If it gets adopted there, you can bet they'll be checking it out here in Louisiana.
Okay. Well, I can't think of nothing else, Donnie, but I do want to make a shout out. Janet Rose, who launched Leeville, and all the things she's been doing now to save the coast has been eroding. They're talking about graveyards down there. She is always involved. She may not always be popular, but she is a bulldog when it comes to taking care of the coast and taking care of Leeville, her favorite place that she found by accident over there fishing with a guide. And now she just fell in love, and she works hard on it. Anything that has to do with the coast, saving the coast, they're going to honor her. Don, you read this from me.
April 17th is the Coastal Restoration Stewardship Award presented by the Coalition to Restore Coastal Louisiana. Congratulations to Janet and all those folks who do so much on a volunteer or professional basis in helping restore our coast.
Just like you were talking about.
It's so important.
Just like you were talking about
Ryan Lambert. He's one of many.
And you know, and the things that she do is not self-serving. Some of these things are going to hurt some of his business. But you got to think about the future. Everybody wants to say, they're worried about saving the swamp, you know. They're worried about the alligators about to eat them right now, but they ain't worried about who's going to drain the swamp.
Speaking about thinking about the future, Gary's got on his future plans some of our editor Chris LeCocq's backyard barbecue, some grilled teal breast wrapped with bacon and stuffed with cream cheese.
Oh,
and
you gonna let me
all
eat
right,
now?
Here we got to go. He's busy now. We'll never get
now
him off the train. We'll see you next week right back
you
here
better get
for
cold.
Another edition of Paradise, Louisiana.
Well, good God.